Question is from Romine Tyler. Since repetitive movement injuries are so common in the construction world, what kind of lower back work would you suggest to keep our back strong and healthy for years to come?
Now, when you look at the lower back, you look at the spine, the lumbar spine, it's not just the muscles of the lower back that support the spine. It's all the muscles that surround the spine, which include the muscles of the core, the obliques, internal obliques, the abs, the transverse abdominis, the muscles underneath both those, all the pelvic floor muscles, all the muscles that surround the lower back support the lumbar spine. So what should you do? You should do exercises that strengthen them through full ranges of motion. You should do exercises that strengthen them as they stabilize. So a good example, a simple exercise that helps you strengthen stabilization of the core would be like a plank, or, you know, farmer walks is another good example. One arm farmer
hollow
walks.
Hollow body.
Yeah, hollow body. That's a great exercise. You want to do rotational movements with like cable chops, and then you want to do counter rotational movements. This is where you're resisting your body's ability to rotate. You want to really strengthen the entire the whole area surrounding the lumbar spine to help protect your spine.
Well, along those lines too, I'm going to give you some generic advice too, because I've trained a lot of construction workers, and two areas that I tend to just spend a lot of time focusing on to help them. Hip mobility and training your abs and core. Obviously, core and abs it's the antagonist muscle to your low back, right? So it's what supports the low back. So if you have low back issues or you have a weak low back, strengthening the opposing side is going to be a great strategy. Period. So having strong core, strong abs is a must for somebody like this. And then, you know, a lot of times low back pain, people don't realize too, just it comes from the lack of mobility in the hips. And because the hips get so locked up and tight, it pulls on that low back because it's all interconnected. And so I found I had a lot of success when I got a client to really open up their whole hip, open up their hips by doing exercises like the 90-90 or like Doug's favorite, the Frogger, and doing moves like that that really promoted good hip mobility and then strengthening the core to support it. And then, of course, the things that the boys were alluding to too, I think are very important to strengthen and have a strong back. But a lot of times the chronic pain that we feel, and this is near and dear to me, like the pain that was from my low back was more due to the lack of mobility that I had in my hips, and then it was then pulling on my low back and causing that. So
much like with the hip flexors, like that's one of those things you got to make sure while doing those types of exercises that we're stimulating, you know, the abdominals, the transverse abdominals. We're not, you know, overemphasizing the hip flexors, which are probably already, you know, in a shortened position and, you know, being overly, you know, like underutilized and not in an extended position very often.
Didn't you write a really good low back pain guide?
Yeah, we have one at mindpumpfree.com, and it talks about some of this stuff. Here's something else. Start to change the technique that you use at work. You know, working with, I never did this as a trainer until I owned my own studio and I had a physical therapist that worked in there, and she was exceptional. I learned quite a bit from her, and I would see her training her clients who worked in, you know, these types of jobs, and she would definitely do the stuff I talked about earlier, strengthening the core, you know, stabilization exercises, counter rotation, all that kind of stuff. But then she would also work on their technique at work. And what she found was, or what I actually observed was, oftentimes their technique was bad because of what you said, poor mobility, like here's an easy one, poor hamstring mobility. Okay, so if your hamstrings are really, really tight, every time you bend over, you're going to really round your lower back and your hips are going to be tucked underneath you.
Great point.
So she would work on their hamstring flexibility and mobility, and then their technique changed. Now when they bent over, it was more at the hips, less at the lumbar spine. So that's something else you can pay attention to. As far as pain relief is concerned or speeding up your ability to recover from lots of repetitive work, stretching after work makes a big difference. Sauna use can help, and red light therapy. Red light therapy on your low back will likely speed up the recovery process that's happening with those muscles.